This is Ron Fellman with breaking news out of Egypt. We've been tracking this story for quite some time now, and before we go to our embedded reporter, we want to bring you up to date with a quick review of what's been happening.
Came here as free men, let them leave as free men.
We've given you our labor and our blood for 400 years. Now you give us something. Our freedom.
My people built this. They created the wealth of Egypt. Is their freedom too much to ask in return?
This is Reuven Fellman, embedded with the Israelites in Egypt. But are they going to be in Egypt for much longer? I know you've had a review of the story to date, so let me take you right to the current events. We were with the Israelites as they left the Pharaoh's palace and their slaves' homes. We were there as they departed the gates. Thousands of them, hundreds of thousands of them, estimated to be 600,000 men, and with women and children, almost 2 million people. They didn't even have time to allow their bread to rise, and so they left with something they're now calling matzah. Well, they headed out, and it wasn't long before the Pharaoh changed his mind and sent his troops after the Israelites. But they went forward until they reached the Reed Sea. And they had no place to go. And they looked behind them, and there were the Pharaoh's chariots. They were upset with Moses, that's to say the least. But then Moses said to have faith, and he raised his staff. And well, we're going to let the pictures speak, because the words cannot describe what happened. Some would call it a miracle. You decide for yourself. And then, when the Israelites made it through to dry land, the Egyptians ventured forth into the split sea. But they never made it to the other side. For Moses' God collapsed the waters back upon them. That's our story for now. It's a tragedy and it's a triumph. A tragedy for the Egyptians and a triumph not only for the Israelites, but for the belief in freedom.
Take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space. Because I'm happy.